No, not at all. We're thoroughly outplayed. We can't hide away from that. We thought it was a good toss to win, but we knew that it was a pretty flat wicket, and probably 260, 270 was more like a par score. We weren't able to get off to a fast start. Lost a couple of wickets. We had to rebuild. But then we weren't able to go through the gears in the last 10 overs. I think you've got to give credit to the Sri Lankan bowlers. There's a lot of variety there. They were able to build up a lot of dot balls on us. And more than anything, restrict the boundaries. We didn't score many boundaries today. We knew our batting performance was under par, but we thought that, pressure's a big man, and if we could get two or three early wickets, hopefully that might be enough to, make that pressure count. Unfortunately, Dilshan and Tharanga played outstandingly well. And, it was a very flat wicket. If anything, it got flatter in the evening. So we were thoroughly outplayed. We lost to a better side, and we go home with our tail between our legs. I think I can't fault the energy and commitment and desire that the guys have shown over the course of this World Cup. I think they tried their hardest today, but, we weren't allowed to play by a very good side. I think you could cite tiredness, but I think that would be running away from the issue. We haven't played good enough cricket over the course of this World Cup, and generally I think English teams in the subcontinent haven't played well enough to compete day in, day out. And we are, the latest in a long line of sides that have done that. It's disappointing, we've got to be better than that. On the Ashes, look, that was, certainly my proudest moment in cricket. I think it was probably one of English cricket's proudest moments for a long time, and no one will ever take that away from it. We were very fortunate to be part of that, and that'll live long in my memory, certainly. Since then, things have got tough, there's no doubt about it. We've had injuries to deal with, we've had people that have lost form, and we haven't been good enough in either Australia or this World Cup. I think we've scrapped hard, I think we've shown some fight, which is great. But we haven't had enough quality to go on and win this tournament. That's the reality, and that's what we're going to have to address when we get home. I still think I've got a lot of cricket in me, full stop. But we're going to have to sit down with the selectors at the end of this tournament and plot a way forward for both the Test side and the One Day side. And we're going to have to think about what the best options are, both leadership and personnel-wise. So I just haven't thought about it, and now's not the time to think about it, really. Every decision we've made, we've made it for the right reasons. Some of them have proved correct, some of them have proved incorrect. That just goes with the territory, I think. As I said, I can't fault the players. I think they've put in an exceptional amount of hard graft and effort at a time where a lot of them are feeling pretty jaded. But we haven't shown enough quality. I think that's the reality.